Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Shock with DG. Now, in today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys my best tips to help you improve not only your rank, but also your KD. So if you guys found this video helpful, remember to subscribe, turn the notification bell on so that you don't miss another video like this one. Also, drop a like and comment. Let other people know that the video was helpful and it supports the YouTube algorithm, gets me some extra views. I would appreciate it. Anyways, though, so basically what I'm going to do in this video, kind of try to give you some tips to change your mindset on rank and KD, which I think will overall help you a lot more than most guides you'll find on YouTube here. And I'll give you some quick tips as well on some other things that you've probably heard before, maybe not, we'll see. But if you guys want any more in-depth tips on this, check the links down below in the description. I have my tips playlist down there, and in that playlist I've got like 40 plus videos, probably almost 50 videos now, going over pretty much anything you can think of. So if you guys have any questions, be sure to check that playlist down in the description. Anyways, though, so for the very first tip on how to improve your rank in KD, this may surprise you guys, but it's actually to not care so much about your rank in KD. Now, you may think that's crazy and counterintuitive, but here's my thought process, right? If you're super worried about your KD and rank, you're going to play differently in game. You're going to play more passive, which could be a good thing sometimes, don't get me wrong, but you're going to play more passive on attack, which is going to lose you rounds. It's going to drop your rank. You're going to have less confidence taking gunfights, which is going to reduce your KD. You're overall going to play differently, and you're going to be more scared while playing. And that is not a great mindset to be in when trying to improve. And not only are you going to play more scared and probably lose more rounds because of that and also drop your KD, but you'll also not be focusing on things which actually matter to improve your rank or KD. So a lot of people have this mindset that if they improve their rank and if they improve their KD, they're going to be improving as an individual. And while that can be true, oftentimes what's going to happen is, sure, your KD may go up because on attack you're playing really passive and you're put in 1v5 situations and you get 2, 3, 4 kills. You don't die because you're sitting outside baiting with an ACOG and you really don't have any impact on the round, but you got a bunch of kills, so your KD went up. But oftentimes people's rank will go down with this, so it's kind of easy to see a baiter just look at their KD, and if their KD is really high and their rank is really low, oftentimes they just bait outside and wait for kills. But anyways, basically what I'm saying here is, if you're focusing on improving your rank and KD, you're not focusing on improving the things that you're not good at, such as droning, positioning, comms, crosshair placement, any of this stuff that we're probably going to cover later on in this video. So all of those things are way more important than focusing on just rank and KD, because rank and KD and improving those two things is way more complicated than just getting more kills and winning more games, right? There's a lot that goes into getting more kills and a lot that goes into winning more games. And that's those things that people just aren't paying attention to, because they're more focused on like the broader term of just improving the rank in KD. So to kind of go off of that, I'm going to list you guys a few things on what I think you could do to improve yourself as an individual. And with that, I think it will over time improve not only your rank, but also your KD. So if you're wanting those two things improved, my recommendation, as I just said, don't focus too much on it. Instead, focus on these things that I'm about to bring up. And also check out my tips playlist in the description to check out my other tip videos, which will also probably help you here. So the first one is droning. A lot of people have really poor droning and they're just really bad at it in general. They're either not droning, or they're droning really poorly, or they don't really know what to do with their drones. So I'm mainly talking about on attack here. Something that I see a lot of people do, and this is something that I see a lot in my coaching service. So if you guys are interested in that, check the link down below in the description. What I see in my coaching service a lot as well is like people on attack will just drive their drone straight into the building and get it destroyed instantly, or they'll leave it in some obscure part of the map AFK and they can't pick it up, or it's not close to what they need droned. So my recommendation is to save your drone and either drive it to where you're spawning so you can pick it right up, or leave it outside of the door or window that you like to push into. That's oftentimes what I do. And if you watch my streams, you'll see that I oftentimes put my drone up against like the door that I want to push. That way I could run straight up there, hop on my drone it out, hit the door and go in, right? So enough on droning. Next up is positioning. This is something that's definitely going to improve both your rank and your KD once you actually master it. And this is something that you really need to learn overall to improve as a player. Positioning is one of those things that a lot of people sort of struggle at. And it's something that I can't really help you improve on just in this video, because I can't really tell you if what you're doing is bad positioning or not, because I can't see you play. So for me to really determine whether or not you have bad positioning, I'd have to actually see a clip. And that's something that I really only do in my clip or my coaching service. My recommendation is to maybe record yourself playing. And when you die, ask yourself, is there any chance that I could have not peaked this? Did I have to peak this? Could I have placed myself in a better position, or could I have played this situation any better? And if you answer yes to any of those questions, it's, you know, probably a good chance that you had bad positioning, because there's no situation where you, there shouldn't be very many situations where you have to peak something or you have to push something, right? That's a sign of bad positioning. So kind of record yourself playing, look back on your deaths, and just, you know, ask yourself those questions, which I just said, and determine it from there. Next up is communication. So this is something that a lot of people lack. And I understand if you're solo queuing, it can be kind of rough with the communication, because not a lot of people communicate in solo queue. Trust me, I've been solo queuing a lot lately, so I understand the struggle on that one. But if you are on a five stack, or even if you're just solo queuing, so long as your teammates aren't being super toxic, I mean, just try to communicate with them. Even if they're not responding, just drop some calls in chat, whether it's voice chat, text chat, whatever it may be. If you're on console, I understand it's a little bit more difficult, but you know, just try to figure out some way to communicate with your teammates, if at all possible, because a call out could be, you know, it could seriously be the difference of winning a game or losing a game, or you or one of your teammates getting a kill, or you or your teammate getting killed. So communication, especially in Siege, is super, super important. And this is something that a lot of people just aren't taking into account. So be sure to take this into account. Next up is crosshair placement. So a lot of people, when they ask me how to get better aim or whatever it may be, something that's actually like super important for crosshair placement is aiming in general and just getting more gunfights, is not only crosshair placement, but also positioning, as we touched on earlier. So crosshair placement is super, super important. I think it's the majority of, you know, mechanical skill in Siege. Like, you don't actually need to have insane aim to win a bunch of gunfights in Siege. All you really need is good crosshair placement, because Siege is a one-shot headshot game. One of the things I recommend to practice crosshair placement is to go into a custom game or a terrorist hunt or whatever it may be, and just like compare where, like, for example, the T-Hunt bot's heads are in comparison with the door frame, and just try to track that and aim in at that level every time, and eventually you'll get that down. Anyway, so that's going to be it for this video. If you guys did enjoy, remember to drop a like, comment down below, hit the sub button, I would appreciate it. If you guys are interested in my one-on-one coaching service, the link is down below in the description, as well as my tips playlist. But anyways, hope you have a great day, and thank you so much for watching.
I think you call really fast now on Dokkaebi. I never play her, but...